Hey gang, Evan Sutton here. I'm the senior sound design instructor here at Dubspot in New York City and online. Today we're going to be dealing with Kontakt. I'm going to be contacting you. How do you like that? We're going to be talking about scripts today in Kontakt, which can take your sampled instruments to a whole new level. They can let you do things that you really shouldn't be able to do in a sampler. We're breaking all the rules today. Strap in, make sure you have your emergency contact number. Let's do it. All right, so I've got this track going that I think I want to add some stuff to. So let's go ahead and just listen to it. I'll give you a feel for the lay of the land. I'm getting a little funky these days, and I gotta tell you, I'm enjoying it. I think more bass. More bass? Yeah. More bass. Okay, so that's my track, all right? That's what we're working with. We're going to be talking about scripts today in Kontakt. So let me go ahead and open up Kontakt 5. I've got this instrument here, and I'm going to be looking at the libraries. Now, scripts are really cool in Kontakt. If you're an Ableton Live user, you're probably familiar with MIDI effects. And we don't really have too many of those in a lot of the Native Instruments plugins, but Kontakt has what are called scripts, which are essentially MIDI effects. They can act as MIDI effects. We can do some things with the instruments that sort of go beyond playing them. Okay, so in other words, we're taking MIDI in, it's changing how the instrument responds to the notes that you play. Now, I also want you to keep in mind that scripts are, in fact, where a lot of the information for the factory library instruments is kept. So if you look at the scripts for the factory library instruments, you're going to see a lot of stuff that we don't really have access to because it's possible to program scripts yourself, do custom ones. We're not going to do that. We're just going to use some of the factory ones. But let me go ahead and grab some cellos, okay? And, you know, I'm not advising everybody to have cellos all over their club bangers, although there's nothing wrong with that. But let's go ahead and listen to this. It's a really great sounding cello from the Kontakt 5 factory library. And we've got some different articulations. I can go over here to staccato if I want, if I was going to be like scoring a British soap opera or something. So there you go. Pretty interesting sounding, right? Well, we've got these articulations over here, but we've also got these instrument controls up top. This is a really good example of a script that's been used in a factory instrument. In fact, we have access to scripts a lot like the one that we see here. For example, we can bring up a chord. Right now, that's off. So it's just going to play the note that I give it. But if I turn up this chord knob, we can see that it'll give me a few different intervals. That's an octave. How about a third? And these are always the same interval. They're not what we call tonal. They don't change depending on which key I'm playing. Here's a fifth. How about 1-3-5, a triad? So with these like 1-3-5 triads, we could maybe do this with an organ or something like that, but maybe I'll stick with the staccato cello. But like the 1-3-5, If we just leave it that way and we play a few different notes, we can get some interesting chord structures that are kind of reminiscent of like a 90s house sound. Because the chord quality doesn't change. It's really interesting. But what we can do is we can turn this knob, we can switch it to a key. So if we go over to the key knob, we can click on a key here, and we can also choose a scale here. If I choose major, we're going to hear that if I hit C, then it's a C major chord. Now, if I hit D, you can hear that it's actually a D minor chord, and that's because in the key of C major, D is a minor chord, and that's because we have F above it, and that's the minor third for D, and so that makes D a minor chord. And so you can play your Bob Dylan songs. If you want to make your folks happy and stuff like that. Anyways, so that's a great example of a script. Now, I'm going to show you how you can add scripts to your own instruments. It's a lot of fun. So I'm going to get rid of this now, and I'm going to go to this instrument that I've made myself. It's called Hey Gang, and I'm sure that if you've seen a few of my videos before, you have an idea of what we're talking about. I just took this little sample of my personal voice, the only one I got, and you can see the sample right here. And I can go ahead and play it like an instrument. Let's take a listen.
Hey gang, Evan Sutton here. Hey gang, 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 Evan Sutton here.
OK, can even play chords with it.
Hey gang, Evan Sutton here. 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 Hey gang.
So there's all kinds of things that I could do with this, but we're going to go ahead and add a couple of scripts to it. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go up here to the script editor. If you can't see the script editor, you can find it up here in the navigator just by hitting script editor and go into the presets. All five of these slots can hold one script. Remember, just like MIDI effects in Ableton Live, these scripts are, they affect each other. So whatever happens in one gets passed on to the next one and they take each other pretty seriously. So we can go to factory and I can go into harmonize, for example, and I can grab chord, and I can just choose, it'll make a chord if I just play one note at a time.
Hey gang, Evan Sutton here. 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 Hey gang, Evan Sutton here.
Pretty wild, huh? I can change it to, how about a major seventh chord?
Hey gang, Evan Sutton here.
Pretty good, huh?
Hey gang, Evan, hey gang, Evan, hey gang, Evan, hey gang, Evan, hey gang.
One of my favorites. And then we can also do a tonal version of chord, okay? And what this will do is this will let us be in a key. So we can say C major, and we're going to play 1-3-5, just like we saw before in that cello instrument. Pretty good, right? So I can also change it to like C Dorian, C Phrygian. How about something wild, like the whole tone scale? The whole tone scale is like the classic horror movie scale.
Hey gang, Evan Sutton here. Hey gang, Evan Sutton here. Hey gang, Evan Sutton here. Hey gang, Evan, hey gang, Evan, hey gang, hey gang, hey gang, hey gang, hey gang.
That's for when the killer, you know, busts through the door to find the lovers. And I think we know what happens there. I'm going to go ahead and continue here. I'm going to show you a couple of my favorite scripts, okay? So the first one is actually under performance. And by the way, to get rid of a script, you can either hit bypass or you can go to preset, factory, empty, and just get rid of it, okay? No harm, no foul. But I'm going to go into factory, performance, and I'm going to go ahead and grab unison portamento. I love this script because it lets us do some amazing things with this sampler, things that without a whole lot of work wouldn't really be possible. So the first thing is portamento, okay? We can put this in mono mode if we want, and we can turn portamento on here. And now what I can do is I can go ahead, just turn the time up, and I can create a nice glide effect in my sampler, which is really cool. If you've heard like Pond de Flor, that's a major laser song, and then they sampled it and used it in a Beyonce tune, you know, that kind of stuff. You just load your favorite vocal sample in there, sample of your mom yelling at you, sample of me talking to you, and you can get some wild stuff.
Hey gang, hey gang, Evans, hey gang, hey gang, hey gang. Hey gang, 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 hey gang.
Pretty cool. So there's so much stuff you can do. We can turn on relative and it'll make it so that the time extends depending on how far away the keys are.
Hey gang, hey gang, Evan Sutton here, hey gang, Evan Sutton here.
Pretty good. Impress your friends with that one. Use it at parties. So the portamento is really cool, but here's something that's really cool. Now, once upon a time, my good friend Chris Petty, who's the curriculum director here at Dubspot, came up to me and he said, "Hey, Evan, I was wondering if you could show me how to maybe do like a unison detune in Kontakt because I have these great Moog Minotaur samples that I really want to use." And I said, "You know what, Chris? Actually, there is a great way to do that without a whole lot of work." And he said, "Wow, okay, that's great because I really want to go home and test drive the new version of Reason." And I said, "That's great, Chris. That sounds awesome." So I showed him this. It's really cool. This Unisono Voices area, and we have detune and we have spread. And so I can go ahead and I can,
hey gang, hey gang.
I can go ahead and turn up the voices, and I can get a nice unison detune here.
Hey gang, Evan Sutton here.
Of course, I got to turn mono off.
Hey gang, Evan Sutton.
If I want to play a chord, that is.
Hey gang.
So we're literally just making copies of the note that I'm playing and detuning each one of them a little bit. We can also spread those out over the stereo field. That's one of my favorite effects to use.
Hey gang, Evan Sutton here.
Get a nice big sound.
Hey gang, hey gang, hey gang, hey gang, Evan Sutton here.
I'm sure you guys are going to be hearing these in your nightmares tonight.
Hey gang, Evan Sutton here.
Yes. All right. So that's unison portamento. I love that one. I'm going to show you another one of my favorites. That's under sequencing, and it's called arpeggiator. Simple as that. So we have global settings. I'm going to turn it on. And then we have the overall timing. This is the rate. It's locked to the BPM that you're going with. Right now, I'm at 111. I know that's not a la mode right now for a lot of people, but you know what? I'm doing it. I'm doing it. So we have the rate, that's how often it fires a note, and then we have the duration of those notes. We can swing it a little bit. It's really cool. This arpeggiator basically takes note information we give it and creates a sequence based on the parameters we have set here and the notes we're playing. So I'm just going to hold down a note, and it's going to fire out repeated 16th notes. Bet you didn't think you could do that with a sampler. Okay, great. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to play a chord, and you'll be able to hear that it actually will separate those notes and play them one at a time. Now, I can change the note order if I want. I can have it go up and down. And then I can also add an octave or two. I'm going to say two octaves here. I can have it strike more than once in each octave. I can also change the rhythm up. So we have 16 steps in here, and each one of these little bars represents one of the note strikes. So I can make it so that it's actually playing like a dotted eighth note type of pattern. Okay. Oh, let me pull down the strike and the octave for now. And maybe I can go ahead and play something along with this sequence that I have. And maybe I'll just go ahead and switch it back to the regular 16th notes. I think that might be a little bit more fun for this. So I'll just go ahead and do that. And duration's good. Maybe we'll make it swing a little bit. All right, so I got that. Now I'll just go ahead and record a little bit. Just real simple, just some nice big blocky chords, all right? Nothing too elaborate. Switches up the rhythm there. These two will go up an octave there. Yeah, that's pretty good, and I could even go ahead and I could add a little bit of my octave splitting. That duration might be a little better. There we go. All right, so I've got that, and now I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to go into this next empty slot, and why don't I go ahead and combine that with the performance here, and I'll just go ahead and use unison portamento there, and why don't I just add a couple of voices to make it nice and thick. Here's without. Here's with. And here's without. There we go. So that's my sound. I really like it. It's not going perfectly with everything that I did here, but this is a really cool modification that you can make to some of your instruments. You can come up with some really weird, wild stuff. And also, Kontakt is a great utilitarian piece of equipment, too. It's not just for destroying sounds like I've done, destroyed my own voice and made it into something potentially even more beautiful. No, it's good for a lot of different things. Try putting an arpeggiator on a tuba. See what happens, you know? Impress your friends. Have a lot of fun with it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. This is Evan Sutton. You can catch me at astrolith.net. You can hear some of my releases. I have many other tutorials here on the Dubspot YouTube page. You can find those also on my website. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I'll see you around the internet.
Welcome to Dubspot. We believe in providing you hands-on experience right away. Whether you're completely new to music and want to turn the sounds in your head into a musical reality, or you're an experienced artist looking to refine your skills and add new tools to your arsenal, we're ready to meet you at your level. For students of all ages, all levels, and all styles of music, Dubspot is here to help you achieve your goals. With course offerings both online wherever you are and at our school in the heart of New York City, we are ready to guide you through the next phase of your musical transformation. Whether you want to produce music, DJ, or do both, you've come to the right place. Come explore Dubspot for yourself. Become a part of our community and make music.